All right, y'all, back here at Bell House. Happy Thursday. Let's get ready for the workout. Happy Thursday, rocking the jorts today. Y'all know y'all like them. Y'all know y'all like them. Excited today, get to do a workout that has a movement in it that I suck at. So, opportunity to get better. Get to do it in front of the camera, in front of you guys, which is great. So, better get good at it quickly. So, workout of the day is 18-minute AMRAP. So, that goes for as many reps or as many rounds as possible in 18 minutes. So, we're going to start off with 60 double unders. If you can't do double unders, we're going to do 90 single unders. So that's with the jump rope. Then, 30 reverse lunges. So, that's stepping back into a lunge. It's 30 total. So, it'll be 15 each leg. And then, 15 of those darn reverse burpees again. They're back. They're probably here to stay during this programming. So, get used to them. If you do have trouble really getting the reverse burpees, I want you to really try to work on it. But if you can't do them, we can do regular burpees. If you have no equipment, we're gonna do a 60 plate hops. We did it in other videos before where you're jumping up onto a mat or on a plate. Whatever you can lay down on the ground that maybe has like a inch or two elevation to it, you're gonna hop on and off of that. So we're gonna do 60 of those, 30 odd object reverse lunges. So you can look back at our videos, like a backpack I made, or just kind of anything that has some weight to it that you can kind of hug and go into a reverse lunge from there. And then 15 reverse burpees. You don't need equipment for them mugs, so we'll get to it. All right, guys, for the warm-up today, we're basically gonna be doing two rounds of the workout, but the way it's gonna be laid out, we're gonna do the set. First set's gonna be 20 double unders. If you can't do double unders, just do 20 single unders, that's fine. 10 alternating reverse lunges. The first set is just gonna be done with your body weight. You don't need to hold on to a dumbbell or anything like that. Then it's going to be 5 reverse burpees, so you can get to practicing on those. Second set, that's going to be 10 double unders or 10 single unders, whichever one you're doing in the workout. Then 10 alternating reverse lunges. This time we're gonna do it with the weight we plan on using in the workout. And then we're gonna do 3 more reverse burpees. Let's go over those movements and see what they look like. Hey guys, first movement, double unders. That's just where the jump rope goes underneath your feet twice. Is kind of a fairly complicated movement. Don't expect for you to just grab it and get to going at it. But what it is here, jump rope going underneath your feet twice with each jump. Guys, what I want you to kind of focus on is kind of on your rhythm on it. So if you want to do some double unders before to kind of get used to them. I was talking to one of my buddies the other day, said that one of his big issues when he was trying to get his double unders is he was actually spinning the rope too fast. So really, you don't have to, if you're getting a good tall jump with each one, you don't really have to get a really, really fast spin to it. So just kind of focus on that. Maybe put up a video camera and kind of videoing yourself. If that rope's coming around the third time and you're tripping up on the third go around, and you might be spinning too fast on those double unders. So look into that, timing on the double unders. Like I said before, if you can't do double unders, and we're still kind of working on it, you can either do like a 60 second double under practice in the workout. So for 60 seconds, you just work on your double unders, or you can do 90 single unders. 90 single unders, just regular old jump rope here, okay? Next one is going to be reverse lunges. So holding on to your weight, holding on to your weight here, you can hold it in this kind of this goblet style where you're holding on just to the hex, or you can hold either end of the hex, bringing it close to your body here. But what you're going to be doing is stepping back into a lunge, making sure that knee touches the ground and that lead shin stays vertical. Then you're going to drive back up and then alternate feet each time. Okay? I want to make sure, guys, as you're stepping back here to where your feet are actually still kind of apart. They're not right behind of each other. When you're right behind each other, it can actually kind of mess up your balance right here. Instead, you can bring it just to the side, as you can see in the camera. As you stand back up, that actually gives you a little bit more of a platform whenever you're going through those lunges. Next movement is the reverse burpees. So what I would recommend is grabbing some sort of mat or something if you're not comfortable with the movement. I haven't practiced these at all today, so I'm just going to go ahead and start with that little bit of information. But what you're going to do is you're going to adjust the camera so you guys can see. So it'll go like this. You're going to sit back onto the ground slowly, so bring your hip butt as close to the ground as you can. Lean back, roll those feet forward, and then stand back up. If you're a little bit more mobile, whenever you come to catch yourself, you can actually bring your feet wider and close to you. Problem is, if you lack mobility like me, you have to bring your feet just a little bit closer. It kind of throws you off balance as you're coming up. But kind of the biggest thing that I've found that kind of helps is bringing those feet back and launching them back forward to kind of help you through. So when you sit back down, bring those feet back and then launch them forward. You can go into a crisscross. That kind of helps me sometimes. You got to be careful with it. Or coming back, standing up that way. The more you do them, the better you get at them. It's just one of those things we're going to work on together, getting better at. So let's start the warm-up. Burpees were pretty ugly, but that's okay. We're working on them. That's how you get better at them. Learn to keep those legs as close to your body as you can on those warm-up sets. Kind of helps you stand up on them. So in the workout, make sure you grab a dumbbell that you can see yourself doing all the reverse lunges unbroken every time. So 30 reverse lunges, you should be able to just step them out the whole time. On the double unders, like I said, if you can't do double unders, do 60 second double under practice. That way you're not sitting there just trying to do double unders the whole time. Just do them for 60 seconds and then go on to the next movement. Or you can do 90 single unders. Reverse burpees. Can't do reverse burpees. Regular burpees. We did regular burpees 2 videos ago, I believe. So you can check back on that one just to kind of see what that movement entails. However, most of you guys should kind of know what that is already. Plate hops. Or odd object reverse lunges if you are doing it with no equipment. If you have questions on any of those movements, comment in the video and we'll get to it. Day 16. Glad you guys are still sticking with it, watching these videos. Just a reminder, we announced it yesterday that we are doing a competition. So you post this workout and time lapse it, post it on your story, and get a point. It goes towards your chance at winning a Case of Fit Aids and a Bell House t-shirt. We got some behind me over there right now. Case of Fit Aids, probably going to be the RX Fit Aids. RX sugar free because no added sugar, people. We did get the jorts made another appearance today. Last appearance I think was at the what games was it? Granite Games, I think. She posted a picture here. It was with Alec. He was rocking the shorts with us. Christian did not have the shorts on. He didn't get them in time, so still want to give him a little shout out. Team. Good team for the little competition we did. Guys, the workout was it was a little frustrating at first. Had to check myself a little bit. Remember that you don't just pick up these movements super fast. For some people, especially like me, it takes a little while for me to pick up movements. It's not one of those things that I can just pick up things like super athletic like my wife is. She just picks things up super quickly. So the first round was sketch. Then started getting a little bit more of the hang of it, started feeling a little bit better. It's one of those things, you just gotta try different things, kind of practice it It is not a normal movement that we probably do in CrossFit, but you know, we're trying to change things up, do things that are a little bit different, so it's not, you know, squats and push-ups every day. So hope you guys are enjoying it, liking us, comment if you got any questions on the workout. But guys, keep tagging us, keep going towards that that goal of the shirt and the fit aids. We love y'all. Keep on crushing it. I don't think I have anything else to say. Let me think just for a second. Nope, not yet. Oh, tomorrow, Friday, going to Kim Edwards' house. We're going to do a little home workout over there. I think we're gonna try to do every Friday, going to a member's garage gym. Most of the other workouts will either be done here or maybe Josh will do a couple in his garage. We'll get our other coach in there to Coach B to start filming some videos. So we'll see if that happens or not. But yeah, we will see y'all next time. Have a great Thursday. You're going to sit down here, falling back, throwing your feet up, and you're actually going to